Welcome, Technology Coordinator for Prince George's County Public Schools, Sarah Thomas.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Sarah Thomas, and I'm a Regional Technology Coordinator for Prince George's County Public Schools. So I'm very happy to be here with you at ISTE 17. Woo! So I have one question for you to ponder. So do we learn to teach or do we teach to learn? That's one question to ponder. So I had the opportunity to work with these amazing people that used to be here at the ISTE Standards Technical Working Group. And we worked on these new ISTE standards for educators that were just rolled out today. These standards complement the student standards that were released last year. So it's just amazing how well they integrate. So if you want to see examples of educators living these standards, you can check out edumatch.org, where different educators have given their examples of how they meet those standards. But today we're going to focus specifically on the learner standard, because we as educators are lifelong learners. If that wasn't the case, you wouldn't be here, right? So definitely we're going to talk about learning together, building these collaborative networks, and growing together. So you may have seen the TED Talk by Rita Pearson called Every Child Needs a Champion. In that TED Talk, did she talk about the importance of building these relationships? Relationships are the foundations for learning, and also peer-to-peer relationships are equally as important. When you have that peer-to-peer collaboration between students, then it just works amazingly because they're able to learn together and exchange information more freely. The same thing can be said about us as lifelong learners. So educators as lifelong learners. So whenever we get together and we have these conversations, then you don't just have one brain on the problem, you have multiple brains on any given problem. So I'm gonna tell you a story of one of my good friends, Anibal Pacheco, and he exemplifies learner standard to a T. He mixes the higher education with the professional learning networks, and just catastrophically blows my mind in terms of what he has accomplished. So Anibal started in the military, and he left the military in 2008. At that point, he enrolled in community college and graduated with a bachelor's in 2016 with a 4.0 GPA. He'll be graduating with his master's in 2018. In addition, he's one of the most connected people I know. So I met him on Twitter in 2013, and he is just a sharer. He will share everything to help other educators connect and learn and grow. So, speaking of connections, then my friend Sherry here tells about PLNs. PLNs can stand for Professional Learning Networks or Personal Learning Networks. It's all up to you what you want it to be. And we're a friendly bunch on Twitter and on other social networks, so don't be afraid to jump in. So when you do make these connections and you make these friendships, then the world is your oyster. It's amazing what you are able to accomplish. So these deep connections, they are the foundations of learning. Not only is it important to connect, but it is also important to share your story. When you share your story, then that's how this helps the profession as a whole. That's how we learn, and that's how we grow together. So definitely putting our stories out there, tweeting, blogging, podcasting, writing books, whatever you have to do. I actually signed up for Twitter in 2013, and what brought me here was just the amazing learning that I was hearing about. What kept me here were the connections. Connecting with other educators all around the world to just bring these opportunities to my students. So it's a beautiful time right now to be an educator, because we have pretty much the world at our fingertips, literally, when we go on Twitter, Voxer, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat. We can even come together to help support students, so to help advocate for students. This is one other fantastic aspect of social media. We can get together to advocate. When our students are hurting, when they have issues, we can come together to help support them. So whether you call it a PLN, Personal Learning Network, you would be very fortunate to have one. You're even luckier if you have a tribe. I've been blessed to have what I call a personal learning family, okay? Just like in a family, sometimes you may not see eye to eye, but you love each other, and that love is there. And in times when it really matters, your family are the people who have your back. So I highly advocate that you create a personal learning family for yourselves. So sentence that starts with the why, we're gonna flip that on its head, and I'm gonna end with the why not. Why not be a learner? We owe it to our students to be our very best so that we can be the very best for them. So with over 7 billion people in the world, each of us might only look like a dot on a map, but it's a beautiful picture when we begin to connect the dots. So thank you all so much today for your attention and time, and have a great ISTE experience.
And now, please welcome to the stage for one last song, The Tiara Girl.